Hey, what's up guys? Welcome to another installment of Rossi's Reviews. Today we're taking a look at a gun and a line of guns I'm actually not that familiar with. I've now since got a chance to play with one a little bit, but was not aware of AirForce International. It's a brand that Air Force has that's international, that's a lot of brake barrels and guns that we're not used to seeing here in the States for Air Force. You know, as far as I was concerned, they had a string of guns that were PCPs, very powerful. But we come here now from the international line where we find some brake barrels. So we're taking a look here at the Model 94 from Air Force International. These guns are made out of Spain. You know, most of the guns, the Texan, guns like that are made in Texas. And so that's what I've seen most of from the Air Force line. So now this is a little different. So it's made out of Spain. And you know, this is your typical brake barrel. But as you can see, it's pretty sleek in design, pretty simple. It's your basic black brake barrel gun. Light, easy to shoot, comes in 177, 22, and 25. And you know, it's got your fiber optic sights here with the rear adjustable and the front hooded sight. You can take the hood off as well. It's got your little dovetail in here. So we've got some BKL mounts on here holding an Air Force 4x32 scope. So simple, you know, this is a great setup for your basic brake barrel. It's got a two-stage adjustable trigger. They're mostly just for how much of the stage. You're not gonna be able to really adjust it to, you know, like a 1 pound trigger or anything like that. I mean, it's made for, you know, plinking, small game, pest control, stuff like that. The type of gun you can always have ready at any point. You can grab it, crack it, snap, you know, cock it, and it's gonna fire. It's gonna be reliable. It's gonna stay consistent. They're saying that this thing comes in, you know, at, depending on the ammunition, 1100. I'm sure that's probably at a 177 with a 5 grain pellet. That's not very accurate. But we've got a 22 here, and we're gonna take a look at that. We're gonna shoot it through the crony, get some speed, shoot it at 25 and 50, and then we'll take it over the fun range and try to see what kind of damage we can do over there on some fun targets. Before I get to that though, the thing that makes this different and that sets us apart from the average brake barrel that you're used to seeing is they have a complete section at Air Force International you can go to, and you can customize this gun. And by customize, I mean different stocks they have set up. This is the walnut with the adjustable comb. They have the regular walnut without the adjustable. They have beech. They have the beech with adjustable comb. They have other composites that you put on with different designs. So it's very simple. I mean, you know, you pop this screw off, pop this screw off, pop these two out, and then the whole piece is going to come out, and you're gonna set it into this. Which, I mean, I think we should do, right? Like, why wouldn't we? If it's something that's different, let's just do it. Let's just see how it goes. I've never done it. We're just gonna do it, right? Here's what's gonna happen. So, like I said, it's two screws. We're probably gonna speed this up. So I'm gonna start unscrewing, commence the speed up. And there you go, ladies and gentlemen, just like that. And pa-pow. Walnut stock with the adjustable comb. That was easy, wasn't it? Now here's what's cool. I want to stop the slow motion before I put this back together. If we wanted to, this is the 22 caliber. If we wanted to, people, at this point, I know, right? You're like, what is happening? Rossi's taking apart guns. It's never gonna go back together. It will, but here's what I wanna show you is another cool thing about the Model 94 is, pull this out, bam, 177 barrel. All I've gotta do, and I can assure you right now I'm not gonna do this, but you would literally cock this down, unscrew this, pop the pin, pull this out, and then bang, you put the 177 barrel on, or the 22 or the 25 caliber barrel on your brake barrel. So not only can you adjust and change out the stock, you can literally change out the barrel, and this can be a 3 or 10 brake barrels in one, because it comes in 177, 22, and 25. Here's the 177 barrel. It looks the exact same. All I gotta do is throw this on and now I got a 177. Or if you have the 177, you buy the 22. If you have the 22, you buy the 25. Or you buy the 25, you put the 22, and you put the 22 on, you put the 177 on. If you have the 25, put the 22 on, then you put the 25 on, then you put the 177 on. I mean, it's your choice, really, let's be honest. It's up to you. But the point is, it's that easy to make the adjustments. I'm not gonna do that right now, because I'll be honest, I don't have time. But what I am gonna do is I'm gonna switch out the stocks just like that, because I wanna show you how super duper simple it is. So now I gotta take my trigger guard from the other stock, right? Pop it on, and bang! And boom, there you go. Hey guys, check out my Model 94 with the amazing walnut stock with adjustable comb, just like that. See guys, and there you go. Now I take my composite stock, which is nice, nice and black, right? And I get something, if I wanna put a little pizzazz in there, that sets apart. Still works, cocks. And shoots. So there you go, that's the thing that makes this very basic looking, run-of-the-mill brake barrel gun a little different than the average brake barrel that you see out there. It's that simple. You've seen, if I can do it, trust me, you can do it. A couple of screws, there you go, and like I said, you can change up the barrels, which is pretty amazing. So, now that it looks like I want it to look, looks nice and sleek, let's go ahead and get things going. Let's check some chrony, let's check some feet per second, let's do a little grouping here at 25 and 50, and then let's get to the fun run, shall we? Yes, we shall. All right, here we go. Gun looks good. I look good. Yeah, you heard me. Here we go, 25 yards. .707. I'm going with the JSB 18 grain pellets. You know, it's kind of a middle to high weight for a 22, but 18 is kind of where I like my 22 calibers. I guess it's kind of middle of the road, really. 699. Ooh, woo! 706. .704. So there you go. So low 700s with an 18 grain. I'm sure if you moved, you know, a little bit lower. 12 grain, 15 grain, probably move a little bit faster. You know, a little bit higher to 20, 22 grain. It's gonna get a little slower. It's not a bad five shot group at 25, 704. So I mean, all five shots right there. One drop below 700, but within 5 feet per second. Those are all pretty much within, gosh, a dime of each other. They're all touching. So, you know, we're outside, we're moving. I mean, who knows? Maybe I could have put them all in the same hole in a controlled environment. Let's move up to 50, see the difference. And this is a nice, again, this is your consistent, nice, reliable, like ready to go, you know, caliber, a 22 caliber brake barrel. I mean, this is what you're gonna, you know, we're gonna use. So here we go, let's do a little five shot group ski. Down there at 50. Now the safety's back here. It's pretty simple. It's an automatic safety, so when you cock it, it goes to safe. So it's right there by your thumb, which I love, because as you're getting ready to shoot, you can just push that whenever you want to. You know, I know we didn't really look at the stock, but just taking a look at it, you know, it's got some nice texture on the grip and here in the stock where you can hold it. So you know, this up here is going to be mainly. I don't know that it baffles. It's mainly for just a cocking, you know, handle, and it looks cool. This thing's, it's pretty quiet overall, you know, but it's got the, you know, rubber buttstock that's not adjustable. It's just there. You can't adjust this comb. This is like a $50 or $60, with like $60, something like that. If you want to get this stock, it's a nicer stock. I could be wrong on the price. Don't quote me, but it's somewhere around there. And then there's like $100 stock. There's like $20 stock. So this is a nicer stock. So, and it makes this gun look a little bit nicer. All right, let's continue at 50 yards and see what we can put together. so I'm still kind of, I'm aiming for the top. I didn't know how much of a drop I was going to get, so I'm aiming top center. And then, it keeps playing. 692, so everything's in the high 600s right now. It's 690, 696, 695, 692. Ooh, now that thing pushed off to the right a little more than I would have liked to. 697. That's right in that same hole. 697 again. There you go. So that's a pretty solid five shot group. So 25 yards, 50 yards, pretty good groups at 689. So everything's that low 700s. We've seen 689 to like 706, which is a good string. I mean, if you can shoot all day, every day between those numbers right there with an 18 grain pellet, you're looking pretty good. You got to think that's about 18. That's like about almost 20 foot pounds. You're getting with a break barrel on a 22 caliber. So like that's fantastic. At 671, the foot pounds equals the weight of the pellet. So I'm shooting an 18 grain pellet. We're shooting at 689, 690. So that's over 671. So it's at least 18 foot pounds. You know, could be 19, could be 20 foot pounds based on the math, but it's somewhere right around in there. Again, 22 caliber, you don't need or want much more than that. And for a break barrel, that's perfect. Accuracy, good. Let's take this sucker to the range and get some stuff done, shall we? We shall. All right, it's time to hit the old fun range with the Model 94. Here we go. You know, this thing again, very accurate over on the range. I can't imagine anything less here, but we're gonna put it to the test, shoot some little targets, big targets. We got targets starting at 20, running all the way out to 50, big, little, and everything in between. So here we go. I think I like that red dinosaur right there. All right, other little things. Green dinosaur. Take that, green dinosaur. I'm going back to the black thing. Army guy. Just caught him in the finger. Bowling pin. All right, army guy. There we go, army guy. White cup on the end. Boom! The Model 94's got some pretty good power. That's what? That's 30 yards. I'll go cup. Bow! I love it. All right, I gotta hit me some blast caps out there deep at like 60. Nice! Oh, too high, too high. Far right. Ah, not enough air pressure. It's all right. That's all right, we got another one. Oh. Got it, but not enough power. Well, we got one more shot here at a big old bottle. And I think we're gonna send the old Model 94 on its way. It's got a new stock. It's nice and broke in. It looks good. I stand corrected. The Model 94 has got the power with a 22 caliber pellet to ignite Tannerite at 30 yards. That's awesome. It can get no better. I'm surprised. That is it. This is an Air Force International rifle. You can get the, you can still get these at Pyramid Air, but this is the Model 94. You can go to the Air Force International page and you can look at all the ways that you can change this rifle, get new stocks, get new barrels, get all the barrels, the 177, the 22, the 25. You can literally customize this thing any way you want. When you add some BKL mounts in, you can kind of do whatever you want. So that's it for this episode of Rossi's Reviews. Thank you guys for watching. Make sure to check out more of our American Air Gunner videos right here on our YouTube page. And of course, tune in to the Pursuit channel for new episodes of American Air Gunner. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time. Make sure to get your hats and your t-shirts. Come on now. I want to see you rocking them. Appreciate it, guys. We'll see you next time.